Hello and welcome. So today's video is working this page out of Seasons, and I am using my Neo Color 2s for the background here. So for the glow effect around the lantern, I apply the Neo 2s straight to the page, and I start with pale yellow and then add a little bit of white around the pale yellow because that is going to be my transition to the blue colors. And so for the blue colors, I use my Caran palette. You could use, you know, a cutting board if you don't have one of those palettes. You can see here I am applying the Neo 2s straight to that palette. And then I'll grab my cup of water with my size 10 round watercolor brush that I love to use. I had grabbed my Tombow water brush pen because I thought I might use it, but I ended up not needing it. So as usual, I will list all of the colors and supplies that I use in the description box below. All right, so as you see here, I'm going to take my watercolor brush, and I have a cup of water and my old rag there to clean off my brush. And I basically just go ahead and activate those colors right on that palette and onto the page, just like regular watercolors. Yeah, so okay, here I got a little carried away with the black pencil and made it a little thicker than I would have liked. So if you're following along, maybe just not do your kitty's chin quite so thick. All right, so going in with that 50% cool gray, I'm going to go ahead and start kind of mapping out where I want my shadows to be, and that will serve as kind of my guide for placing color on this lynx. All right, so here I got a little carried away with my shading and colored in this area between the lynx's legs. And so I go back in and try to erase it as best as I can. But it's going to be fine because it's going to be in shadow once the page is finished anyway. All right, so here I'm using a Faber-Castell white brush pen, and I like it for eyes sometimes because it just gives kind of that real translucent white look. And then sometimes I'll go over that with a little bit of Posca as well. So if you don't have one of these, that's fine. You can just use your Posca pen. And then also I like to go back in with my Prisma colorless blender and kind of fine tune that white highlight area. Okay, so this is the part in the video where I start using flicking motions to create the fur for this lynx. And I do multiple layers with different colors of pencil to create, you know, more realistic look. So I guess what I end up with is kind of a semi-realistic look. It's best I can do, you know, so, there will be a lot of layers added, starting with this slate gray and, just kind of building up the layers until I feel happy with the look. right, so this is about where I'm going to end part one for this page. I hope you've enjoyed the color along. Leave any comments or questions down below. And don't forget to hit that like and subscribe button if you haven't already. And I'll see you for part two.